It's your boy Zap King, the Giant Robots. Welcome back to Super Wars X. Not GC. Previously, Garma decided he was going to get in our way. And so today, as is tradition with the one-year war, we have to make Garma not get in our way anymore. Let's shoot some robots. The episode 8, stage 8, Kanmachiru, Garma's Fates. Char and Garma are planning their next move against the White Base. Garma's glad to have Char here as support with him. Garma then invites Char to a small party that he's holding. At the party, Genius thanks everyone for their involvement with the Ospalos project, which he has finished in the first phase. Garma says they're counting a lot on Genius' project, and he says that that's why Lord Degwin gave him so much funding. He's glad to be of help. Isarina, I guess that's who this might be? No, those are girls. Just random girls. There we go. Isarina then greets Garma, and notes that Isarina had been talking over it to Ina earlier. Garma tells Ina to join the party, but excuses himself and Isarina. Ina herself isn't feeling too well, and thus excuses herself. Here we go. Out on the veranda, Norris asks why Ina came here. She says that it's all for her brother's dream. Ina says that if the Ospalos is completed, the war will change, but a lot of people are going to die. Norris says that he will pay that price, since his life is devoted to the Sahalin household. Ina notes that with her bloodline, her reputation, her honor weighing upon her, sometimes she just feels like a puppet for all of these things, and she's a little jealous of Isarina, who's freed from this to be with her man. At the bar, Garma asks if Isarina's father still will not accept his daughter, being in love with the son of the ZEON Dukedom's leader. But she says that he doesn't care about the Federation or ZEON. Even if she betrayed her father, she will be at his side. Garma says that once he finishes with the project, the White Base, his father should listen to his requests. A soldier intervenes, informing Garma of the White Base's location. Garma orders a gown to deploy immediately along with alerting Char. On base, Mayo is surprised that Garma isn't asking for their help. Char says that Garma has a lot of confidence this time since the White Base is near the border. That is one of Zeon's strongholds. Genius says that the Ospalos prototype is ready for use, and it would be a good test to put it against some other ship like the White Base. Char understands this, but Degwin is Gundam Wing, so that's just another bad spelling of Degwin. Lord Degwin expends a lot of the Ospalos project, and they can't afford for it to be shot down. Genius doesn't like hearing this, though his body is in no shape to argue. Char tells him to go away and get some rest. He'll take care of things here, and if the conditions are good, he'll request the Ospalos to be deployed. Meanwhile, the White Base is in the ruins of a city, with ZEON forces closing in on them. Raiden decided to hide the White Base inside the ruins of a dome, and for all pilots to be on standby. Armor is a bit annoyed that they're not really soldiers, but Bright is ordering them around like they are. but Light taps on to knock it off since no one likes fighting, but they have to make it until Jabara. Chiro tells Armo that he understands how he's feeling, but they all have to work together to survive if he wants, and he wants Armo's help. Armo tries to tell Chiro that that's not what he was trying to say, but apologizes for troubling everyone. A Gal fleet has arrived and begins bombing the city, trying to lure the White Base out. There's plenty of people on the Y base that are scared, and want to ask why they're just sitting here hiding! You should go out and kick ass, take names, whoop that ass! Gary explains to Wata that with their supplies being limited, they have to pick their fights carefully and avoid fights that can be avoided. Garma has decided to search for the White Base on foot, but Char volunteers. Garma tells Char that once he finds White Base, he should tell him at once so he can take the gouge and destroy it. Wright says that the enemies are now on foot and they can deploy the forces to lure the enemy to the ship and lure the enemy ship into White Base's firing range so they can sink it in one concentrated barrage. Alert here. And now we choose the rest. Mechanic, a tank. High mobility, hover truck, and the 8th MS. Yet. Nobody knew, nothing new. Let's keep this up. Now, as it is, while the goal is to get Garma over here, we don't have to do anything special. It'll just happen. Just don't shoot him down. Oh no.
Char!
Shield defensor!
Oh
wow! Sniped the head, huh? Good thing I defended, shit! Damn! Lock on. I gotta remember that. Casting spells has a function. Saw plenty of this stuff last time. Fortunately, yeah. What? You need morale to do to rude. Well then, what the fuck spell did I just cast? Let me find out that that's the one that ignores special barriers and shit. Well, let's not snipe. Huh? How come I'm not seeing that? There's a lot of data missing on this page, turns out. Yes. Yeah, this doesn't match up with GC stuff. Once again, the large differences. Time to hold the phone up. Direct hit. Only once a player ignores special defenses. Yeah. Yeah, that's not over here on the GC list. But self-destruct is. Who would even have self-destruct? Whatever. That's a letdown. How far can we move? Got it. There we go. Go to bed, Char. Take a nap. Oh, wait. I was looking at stuff. I guess at some point Char would have noted that the white base isn't coming out. Their mobile suit troops are trying to lure the Gal fleet somewhere, which means the white base should be inside that dome. And it's not a bad plan, actually. But then Char is taken out by Armor. He says he doesn't have to give it everything he's got this time and bails out. However, he tells Garma that the white base is beyond the area where the enemy mobile suits are retreating. See that dome over there? See that dome? Yeah. It's over there. Char rats us out. Char also didn't use his repair kit. Come on, crush him! That's the move. Hey, leveled up the potential in support. Nice. Nice.
とどめた。
貴様らに大義はない。
戦闘行動に支障はありません。ここはブラストソードを使いましょう。
分かったわ、フェアリさん。ブラストソード！えぇ！
リミッター、解除します。フレア、拡大。
オッケー！グレードバーニング！これで終わりよ！
ひるむな、反撃を。
That dock needs to go. Alright. You're fine, just could be better. What? Get fixed, my boy. Barely got fixed. That would be overkill. Nice, potential is up. What? Hold up.
Hold up.
Hold up, I think this is one of those ace things. What did we get? Acquired skill ace. Shoot down skill ace acquired. Increase funds when the enemy is shot down. Oh, fuck yeah. Man! Why'd that have to go on Trider?
I don't like Trider.
Oh wait, let's make sure you're not gonna get wrecked. Oh wait. Thank you. Then two more. There. Because Saishin Ace also has its own bonus. Aces in this game are interesting. Crush that boat! Although I guess that is kind of dumb considering I didn't get that extra dollar off of it. Who's left? What? Oh, hover truck. Hello. You defended. Nice. Now you're here to just plink everything down to critical. Poor fairy. Ooh, another ace, another ace. Oh man, I didn't want that. Get that out of here. All these extra apps, all I need is YouTube and Translate. What do we got? Defensive ace. Defense plus 10 and armor plus 10%. Yo. Cool. I guess that's from taking hits. Get hit. Become good. And Akumi levels up. Oh, you're out of range? Defend? Okay. Oh, you trying to snipe me, sir. And smash. Now, always weapon. Not me more reinforcements. Ah, now he moves. Oh Lord, he coming. Host has Trusto. Ryu. Also have trust? Yes. Sir, I noticed you were trying to take me out. Gonna try.
Take his shindo guns. Semerated by Yarishanoga.
Yatay. Atare, Atare, Atare. Atarga.
Get in you. Okuda.
Oh wait, wrong button. Crunch. Get your weapons out of here. Ow! I smacked my hand on my headphones. That hurt. Might have been audible too. Oh, I can counter? Oh, you have shit chance to hit that boy. Just don't. Try. Nice. I should defend. What? Did they move? What happened? What actually the fuck happened? Also, hello, Starman. I forgot I had the chat not up. Thank you, Jose. View, Jose. So... yeah, she moved, right? They both moved? Level up. Yeah, but this means that the spell list is incomplete on both the GC and XO page because neither have Fury or direct ahead. But you said it was Fury. Oh, you know what? Yeah, it is. It just... it doesn't... the shapes of the letters are not the same. his booty. Can you hit from back here? What can you hit? Lock on! That's not lock on, you dumbass. Bless up. Which means somebody has to plink off that last part. I guess I should have gone with the support. That is almost all enemies are gone. Oh, Jesus. Is that what we're doing? You're telling me Alro doesn't have lock-on. That's fine. Kai doesn't have lock-on right now. I accidentally cast Iron Wall instead of Focus. Are your legs fucked up? Yeah, a little bit. Also, Armuro's head is a little jank. Well, I don't know that yet. I haven't gotten that far. Stage 8. I play as I go. It's more fun that way. Ah, dang it. No, always weapon first. I know control's at the top of the list, but come on, man! And her head's been the break. I need to move people away from Garma, because he didn't move forward at all. Okay, time to retreat. Now I'm going to get the dodge ace bonus. I think you still need to earn a get hit bonus. Fuck. I know, right? I got greedy, and Hayato got shot down. Now that I've cleared the road for Garma, maybe he'll go forward. Restoring the gauze HP, that's silly. And fuck! That's me not paying attention to shit. Uh-huh. See, I thought that was going to avoid for some reason. Don't ask me why.
ZEON の理想を阻む者には死あるのみ。
ヤツめ、一体何を狙ってんだ。
Bruh! What's with these numbers today? Calm the fuck on. No, not on. Hey, there's that defense ace. Taking the hit for me. Garma, come the fuck on, man! And fuck it. Oof. They're all gonna go off to the fucking hover truck, I can tell. That's arms. And goodbye. Fuck. This went south. This is getting a replay. Cause fuck. I got greedy and it fucking exploded in my face. As many of these robots have. Not attacking shit, we're just getting the fuck out because I'm tired of reinforcements showing up. Huh, he moved two spots. Uh-huh. So that did happen. That's wild. Now we're so far away, if reinforcements show up, barely matters. We'll be right back. Dang it. Come on, Garma. Get the fuck over here already. Move is 1-3, which means you have to pull back any one space to solve this fucking problem. Boy, hello. Welcome to amazing gameplay of stage that has gone terribly wrong. I mean, I've lost 3 units, and normally, I don't let that happen, but I'm an idiot. And I'm gonna replay this stage. Because, holy shit, that's whack. Jesus fuck! Four fucking units down. God damn. Okay, Gar is telling Char where the white base is, which is, oh look, it's right there. Everybody fucking converge. Right, sees the gal is about to pass him and orders all up into prime to get the engine started, and as soon as the white base attacks. Count it down. Booty! The Gao is there, which really Garma decides to turn the Gal around and kamikaze itself into White Base. Char's voice comes over the intercom, speaking to Garma. Garma, if you can hear this, curse yourself for being born. You were a good friend, but your father wasn't such a good man. Char! Char, you tricked me! Right says that the Gal is about to run itself in and orders me right to raise altitude and bail out to get out of its path. The Gal crashes, killing Garma, but the White Base is, fine. Karen points out that it isn't just a trick that they've survived the song. Walter says that this is what is called strategy, and he should take notes so he and his staff can tell him what's good, but shouldn't forget to study his normal curriculum also. Walter tells him to stop reminding him of that of such things. Perry points out that the plan almost went too well, as if they had an unknown collaborator, but puts that out of her mind. Fuck. Hey, Serena is shocked to learn of Garma's death, as is Genius, Ina, Mayo, and the practice squad. Genius points out that they should have deployed the Aspalus, and Garma was one of the few people who truly supported his project. Back on the White Base, Brand hopes that the enemies will stop harassing them for a while. Midnight tells them that while the ship is fairly fine, everyone's at their physical limit. Shido and Ryu agree that the pilot's stress has been building ever since they left Psi 3, especially Armorers. Might be best not to put them on duty for a while. Bright says that he'll leave personnel management to Shiro. Ryu also says that one of the ground-type Gundam's head was damaged as a result of the blast from the Gal's kamikaze, and they've had to visit with what they have, and the results aren't pretty. Bright says so as long as it moves and it fights, fucking whatever. And thus we get the ground-type Gundam with the gym head. So, yep, ground type gym head doll. All right, well, good night, Space Knights.